Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about genetic engineering for plant abiotic stress tolerance. A variety of abiotic stresses cause crop loss about 50% or even more. That's why transgenic plants are targeted to solve this problem. There are different types of abiotic stresses, which is also called as environmental stress, such as drought stress, salt stress, high temperature, and cold stress. There are 7 approaches in genetic engineering which helps in solving the abiotic stress in plants. They are engineering of genes for osmolite biosynthesis, engineering of genes encoding enzymes for scavenging active oxygen, engineering of genes encoding LEA proteins, engineering of genes encoding heterologous enzymes with different temperature, genetic engineering of molecular chaperones, engineering of genes encoding transcription factor, genetic engineering of cell membranes. These are the 7 approaches. Engineering of genes for osmolite biosynthesis. Tolerance to abiotic stress has mainly been achieved at cellular level of osmotically active solutes like proline, glycine, betaine, sugars such as sucrose, trehalose and fructanes, sugar alcohol like sorbitol and mannitol. These osmolites are uniformly neutral with respect to cellular function. Accumulation of these molecules helps to retain water within the cell and protect the cellular compartment from injury caused by dehydration. Maintain turgor pressure during water stress. Stabilize the structure and function of certain macromolecules. Signaling functions or induction of adaptive pathway. Scavenge reactive oxygen species. Proline accumulates in many organisms in response to drought and salinity. Proline is encoded by nuclear gene pyrrolidine C carboxylate synthetase, which is also represented as P5CS. So we have to remember this, that is the gene which encode the proline is pyrrolidine 5 carboxylate synthetase, which is represented as P5CS. Proline may serve as a hydroxyl radical scavenger, reducing the acidity of the cell. It may also function as an osmolite and molecular chaperone, protect protein integrity and enhance the activity of different enzymes. Glutamate can be achieved by using P5CS. As I already told, this is pyrrolidine 5 carboxylate synthetase gene from moth bean. Antisense proline dehydrogenase in transgenic Arabidopsis. However, P5CS limiting enzyme in proline biosynthesis feedback inhibit by proline. However, the P5CS limiting enzyme in proline biosynthesis feedback is inhibited by the proline. Remove this feedback inhibition by site-directed mutagenesis, and the resulting gene is same as the same gene what I already mentioned, P5CS. Since it is inhibited by site-directed mutagenesis, we will add this F129A. So the same gene along with the site-directed mutagenesis process has been took place. So it has been named as P5CSF129A. These are certain transgenic plants for proline, such as Oryza sativa, Nicotiana tobacum and glycine moss. And what are the performance of the transgenic plant? That is, in case of Oryza sativa, drought and salt tolerance has been seen. In addition, it has also shown increase in biomass, that is fresh shoot and root weight was increased. Whereas in case of Nicotiana tobacum, oxidative stress or oxidative and osmotic stress tolerance was seen.
Additionally, the removal of feedback inhibition resulted in twofold high proline than the plant expressing P5CS. Drought and heat tolerance was seen in glycine marks. Along with it, rapid increase in proline result in least water loss under drought stress. Glycine betaine. Glycine betaine accumulates in chloroplast and plastids and increase the tolerance of plant to various abiotic stress like drought, salinity and freezing. The physiological role of glycine betaine in alleviating osmotic stress. It can also protect proteins and enzyme activities under water deficit and stabilize membrane during freezing. It can help stabilizing the protein tertiary structure and prevent or reverse disruption of tertiary structure. Accumulation of glycine betaine is limited due to choline supply. Transgenic potato plants expressing the bacterial choline oxidase gene leads to high level of glycine betaine under drought stress. These are some of the transgenic plants for glycine betaine. Like for example, in case of Oryza sativum, the transgenic plant was tolerant to drought and salt. In addition, they have shown higher yield under stress condition. In case of Zia maize, drought tolerance at seedling stage has been seen in the transformants. And in addition to that, grain yield was significantly higher compared to that of a wild type. Sugars and alcohol. Accumulation of sugar related compounds responds to osmotic stress. These compounds stabilize the membrane and protein during dehydration. Sugar can replace water molecule and stabilize the protein or membrane in similar of water molecule. They can form glass phase in the dry state of high viscosity, have capable of slowing down chemical reaction, lead to long-term stability in the living system. Trehalose. Trehalose are a rare non-reducing sugar. Trehalose protect the biological molecule in response to different stress condition. It does not accumulate in high enough level in most plant, probably because of the presence of trehalose activity. Trehalose synthesized in two-step from glucose-6-phosphate and uridine-diphosphoglucose via trehalose-6-phosphate. The first step is catalyzed by trehalose phosphate synthase and the second is trehalose-6-phosphatase. Now these are certain transgenic plants for trehalose. Example is Lycopersicum esculentum, which has shown drought and salt as well as oxidative stress tolerance. In addition, they have a sustained yield under all stress. Saccharum officinarum has shown drought tolerance. Transgenic plants did not weather even after 10 days of water deficit and also exhibited no pleiotropic effect. Fructose and other carbohydrates. Fructose or polyfructose molecule serves as a main storage. However, fructoins are to be involved in abiotic stress tolerance by virtue of their presence in vacuole. Fructones are also thought to protect plant against drought and cold stress. Evidence of this was derived from transgenic plants. It acts as a regulator or signal molecule, thus influencing plant metabolism or scavenger of reactive oxygen species. It promotes the process of root branching, thus increase the root surface and subsequent water uptake. These are certain transgenic plants for fructanes. Example is like Nicotiana tobacum. The function is Nicotiana tobacum and Beta vulgaris, and the function was drought and salt tolerance. Engineering of gene encoding enzyme for scavenging active oxygen. Plants suffer from various stress which lead to overproduction of active oxygen species in the cell. To minimize the damage, effects of active oxygen, plants produce antioxidant to detoxifying harmful oxygen. Genes encoding enzymes with antioxidant capacity such as ascorbate, peroxidase, superoxide dismutase, and glutathione reductase. Transgenic alfalfa overproducing superoxide dismutase showed reduced injury of water deficit and freezing stresses in field condition. Engineering chloroplastic superoxide dismutase in tobacco led to an increase of chilling tolerance of photosynthesis. Tobacco plant that overproduced cytosolic ascorbate peroxidase showed increased tolerance to oxidative stress. Engineering of genes encoding LEA protein. LEA means leaf embryo abundance. Gene encoding LEA, that is leaf embryo abundance protein, is activated under osmotic stress. LEA proteins play a role in desiccation tolerance during seed development and in response to dehydration, salinity, and cold stress. Maintenance of protein or membrane structure, sequestration of ions, binding of water, operating and molecular chaperones. HVA1, a group of 3 LEA protein from barley, and LE25, a group of 4 LEA protein from tomato. Rice plant transformed with barley LEA gene HVA1 possessed increased tolerance to water deficit and salinity. Improved salinity and freezing resistance has been observed in yeast transformed with LE25. Engineering of genes encoding heterologous enzymes with different temperature optimal. Homologous proteins and their specific enzymatic activities from different plant species differ in terms of their temperature. Example, when the gene of NADH hydroxypyruvate reductase from cucumber, higher optimum growth temperature was transferred to tobacco, a lower optimum growth temperature, the optimum temperature of transgenic tobacco was increased. Genetic engineering of molecular chaperones. Chaperones assist and maintain correct folding and trafficking of the cell proteins, are crucial for plant to survive in abiotic stresses. Example, an antisense inhibition of heat shock protein, HSP means heat shock protein 70 family, prevent Arabidopsis plant from acquiring thermotolerance. Heat shock protein, that is HSP101, from soybean, corn, wheat and tobacco complemented a thermotolerance defect in yeast caused by deletion of yeast HSP104. Engineering of genes encoding transcription factor. Responses of plants to abiotic stress are multigenic and a single gene is not likely to induce the whole cascade. Recently, transcription factors for abiotic stress induced genes have been identified, cloned and used in transgenic experiment. Simultaneously, expression of downstream stress induced genes have been achieved with parallel increase in stress tolerance. Overexpression of transcriptional activator CBF1, that is C repeat binding factor, induced expression of 4COR, that is a cold regulated gene, and increased freezing tolerance of Arabidopsis plant. By overexpressing the single stress inducible transcription factor DREB1A lead to plant tolerance to freezing, salinity and dehydration. Genetic engineering of cell membrane. Membranes are critical site of injury by chilling, freezing, heat and osmotic stresses. Increased level of unsaturated membrane lipid lead to high membrane fluidity, which improve plant chilling tolerance and photosynthetic parameters. tobacco transformed with acetyl ACP, glycerol 3-phosphate, acyl transferase from chilling tolerant species of Arabidopsis acquired chilling tolerance.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.